of the official party are the Honorable Kenneth Bauer, Mayor of Leavenworth, Secretary Clyde Graver, Director of Kansas Department of Health and Environment, and Ms. Meredith Rausch, President of the Main Street Program. The invocation will be given by Reverend Richard Newkowski, President of St. Mary College. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the posting of the colors and remain standing for the playing of our national anthem and the invocation. Deliver the invocation.
Heavenly God, as we gather today to celebrate the inauguration of 21 way stations that mark the glorious history of this first city in Kansas, our Leavenworth. The citizens of Leavenworth are civic leaders, our Main Street program personnel, and our Convention and Visitors Bureau, and the friends and guests from our surrounding communities ask your blessings on our city today. We ask that you continue to bless those who, through their tireless efforts and your help, made this remarkable day and these way stations possible. Bless all those as well who, through their generosity, made this walk through our history possible. Let those who will share in this good work for generations to come know that what we do here today will honor our history and your guiding presence. Finally, Lord God, as this ceremony of dedication proceeds, help us to be mindful of your special hand in our own histories and our future. And we pray this in your name. Amen.
Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, the Mayor of Leavenworth, Mayor Ken Bauer.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good Lord has blessed us with a great day today. I would like to welcome all of you on behalf of the rest of the City Commission, Mayor Pro Tem Urban and Commissioner Weeks, Commissioner Hunter, who could not be here today, and Commissioner Terry, who we recognize her period dress today. It looks very good, Commissioner Terry. Thank you very much for being here. I want to take a moment to recognize some key folks that are with us this morning. A special welcome to General Mrs. Steele, General Mrs. Wood, General Mrs. Keller, Secretary Graber, so glad you can be here, and Father McCaskey, Mr. Lincoln, and our own Main Street Director, Ms. Roush. Also like to welcome Marty Crow, State Representative, and State Representative Kenny Wilk, and State Representative Kenny Rowe. Thank you all for coming today. To all of the rest of my fellow elected officials and donor organizations that are represented, the historians, the narrators, the artists, and I'd like to give a special thanks to Sergeant Stephanie McGarvey, who is our narrator today. Thank you for being with us today, Stephanie. We really appreciate it. A day like today doesn't happen by chance, if you can imagine. I've had the privilege of chairing a committee of hardworking people that have put this day on. And I'd like to take just a couple moments to recognize those who are here. I'm sure they're all here. They're probably scattered now. Some are still working, probably. But a special thanks to the following people. John Goodman, you stand here, and we'll hold applause until we're all recognized. John is over there on the side. Mr. Wes Ludwig, Laura Morganson from Main Street, Connie Hatchenberg, Convention Business Bureau, Jeannie DeReicher, Mark Berman is here in period costume somewhere, Mr. Tom Throne, Marguerite Strange, and Tom Muller is here, I believe, as well. There he is in the back. Hi, Tom, welcome back. And I wanted to say a special, extra special welcome to two people that have just been tremendously resourceful in helping me put this thing together. They come from Fort Leavenworth, Manny Doyle and Debbie Palmer. Thank you all very much. In addition, I want to recognize a couple of other people who have just joined us to coordinate their program with ours, and to recognize our city staff that has worked so hard to put this program on. A special thanks is due to Larry Hamilton. Larry, are you here? I saw you earlier. He helped put the dock up back there. Thank you, Larry, for that, and to Dave Johnson for his extra special work. And also to certainly our Parks and Recreation Department, Mr. Kasberg, and his folks came down and got the chair set up this morning for us, so thank you very much to all of you. I'm going to begin today by asking a trivia question. How many people out there like to play Trivial Pursuit or trivia-type people? Okay, good. On June the 10th, 1911, 89 years ago today, something very significant happened in the city of Leavenworth. And that's something to do with the Wayside Park. Anybody know what happened 89 years ago? Matt Novak has got his hand raised. I have not planted anybody in the audience for this. I know Jeannie DeReicher knows the answer. Matt, what happened?
Carrie Nation died.
That's exactly right. Carrie Nation died in the city of Leavenworth exactly 89 years ago today. And we're recognizing her with one of the Waysides. So there's something you can file away in your trivia section of your brain. So anybody asks you that question, you'll know the answer now. Well, ladies and gentlemen, today marks the end of a planning process that took approximately 20 months. The dreams of a few have blossomed into a marvelous opportunity to share the history of Leavenworth, Kansas' first city, with one another and with visitors from literally all over the world. Our community, as we know, is blessed with the presence of many international officers and their families who are coming here to study at Fort Leavenworth. And I believe we have created today a world-class project that we can be very proud of indeed. To the best of my knowledge, there is not another city, large or small, in this great country that can boast of such an attraction. Am I excited about today? You bet I am. On June the 12th of last year, we unveiled and dedicated the first Wayside Marker as a tribute to the unsung heroes of our community. It was a festive occasion that brought our community together to celebrate Juneteenth. The first step of changing the dream to a reality had begun. Today, the work is complete, thanks to many of you. When a community dreams and plans, when private businesses and our friends at Fort Leavenworth partner with local government, and dedicated volunteers step up to the plate, nothing is impossible. This project certainly represents all that and more. Once more, I express my sincere appreciation to all of you who have helped make this dream come true. You can be proud of the legacy that we have left for future generations. My only regret is that some of the historical buildings that we highlight on our tour have gone by the way of the wrecking ball. Very unfortunate. Let's pledge to work together to preserve as much of the history of our great city as we can. It is a responsibility West Midwest all take seriously. I hope you have a wonderful time celebrating today. I'll see you around today, especially the fireworks this evening. Thank you all for coming. God bless you all. And at this time, I'm going to ask Mr. Lincoln if he'd like to come up and say a few words.
Thank you. I can say without any question, of all the introductions I've ever had, that is probably the most recent. I also want to point out that my position on this platform does not reflect my politics. I'm not on the extreme of either end. The first time I had the great privilege of coming to Leonard's birth was in 1859. And although the temperature has changed by about 90-something degrees, there's only one thing that's remained constant, and that's the kindness and the warmth of the people of Leavenworth. As I was coming into the city yesterday afternoon, it was just before sunset, just before the sun gave up the day and turned it over to the night. As I was coming up the street, there was a lady walking a dog. The dog, as a matter of fact, was about almost half as big as the lady walking it. And I thought to myself, what a peaceful place. And about that time, the sound of children laughing come across an echo of a playground. And I thought, what a wonderful place to live. What a wonderful place to live, to work, and to retire. And I realize, of course, ladies and gentlemen, that the history of Leavenworth is very deep-rooted. But it's also great to see that Leavenworth is looking towards the future. And so I have to say, ladies and gentlemen, I have to agree with the mayor when he says that, in fact, Leavenworth is the first city in the state of Kansas. So, ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for the great invitation. God bless you. And may this great institution under which we have all lived and prospered for so long, that our future may be made brilliant and the glorious destiny of this country established forever. God bless you and God bless this nation.
Thank you for those kind remarks, Mr. Lincoln. It's my pleasure now to introduce our keynote speaker, who is not a stranger to the city of Leavenworth, certainly. Mr. Clyde Graber, who is currently serving as the Secretary of Kansas Department of Health and Environment since January of 1999. He was appointed to that position by Governor Graves, and prior to this, he had served as Kansas State Treasurer. Secretary Graber has spent many years in political positions, including 12 years in the Kansas House of Representatives for the 41st District. He was the mayor of Leavenworth for 2 years and served on the Leavenworth City Commission for 6 years. Prior to his appointment as state treasurer and secretary of KDHE, he served on the governor's staff as a legislative liaison. Secretary Graber is a former banker. He came to Leavenworth in 1968 as president and chief executive officer of Leavenworth National Bank and Trust Company and retired in 1994. He earned his undergraduate degree and law degree from the University of Tulsa. Secretary Graber has been recognized as Citizen of the Year by the Leavenworth Chamber of Commerce and has been honored with a Smiling Bull Award by the Leavenworth County Bar Association. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a great deal of pleasure for me to introduce Secretary Clyde Graber.
General Steele and other distinguished guests have been recognized. There is one other person, though, that I think we really need to recognize, and that's Colonel Roger Donlan, recipient of the Medal of Honor. Colonel Donlan. Good morning, and it really is great to be back in Leavenworth and see so many faces and friends that I very seldom get to see anymore. I'm happy to share just a few minutes with you this morning as we dedicate these historical waysides that speak out and tell the story of our great citizens of the past and tell some of our historic structures and their part in Leavenworth's past times. Lincoln, Cody, Anthony, Sherman, Harvey, Nation, names that form a part of our nation's historic past, and names that truly are a great part of our city's golden history. It is only right that we recognize these persons and the places where they lived and where they created that part of Leavenworth tapestry. I so well remember my very first visit to Leavenworth in the fall of 1967. I came to interview for a position with one of the financial institutions. Sure, I enjoyed meeting the board of directors, visiting the community, traveling the streets, but when I returned home to Oklahoma, the one thing that I brought forward in my conversation about my trip to Leavenworth was the fact that the bank stood on the very site where Abraham Lincoln had made his first major campaign address in his campaign for the presidency in 1859. The site of the bank was the very site where Stockton Hall stood and was filled to capacity that evening when Lincoln spoke. The man who had debated Stephen A. Douglas, Lincoln spoke of the Kansas Territory and the possibility of it becoming a state, a part of the Union, and the need to maintain the position in opposition to slavery. To me, that incident and its story brought Leavenworth a stature that was unknown to me until my first visit. Abraham Lincoln, probably the most respected and beloved of the presidents other than Washington, had walked these streets. He had been in this community. He remains a part of it today. If that bit of Leavenworth history wasn't enough, I walked across the street and there was a plaque on a two-story white building that formerly housed Manufacturer State Bank. The plaque simply read, cited the original headquarters of Russell, Waddell, and Majors. In 1860, that firm had established the Pony Express to provide weekly mail between St. Joseph, Missouri, and Sacramento, California. Buffalo Bill Cody, then a Leavenworth resident, later of Indian fighting fame, was a 12-year-old boy who became one of the 120 Pony Express riders. Later on, I visited the old Cody home site in Salt Creek Valley, just north of Leavenworth, and that original home site is still there standing. Many communities have taken advantage of their historical past. Why not Leavenworth, particularly when we have so much to tell about and be proud of? These 20 waysides mark 20 of our most historic persons and places. They will tell visitors and travelers much of Leavenworth and its truly meaningful past, certainly its colorful past. Imagine that day in November of 1858 when the first Sisters of Charity arrived in Leavenworth. They got off the steamboat, they climbed the bank, they climbed the hill, and began their work as educators, nursers, and child care workers. What a challenge. Today we see the fruits of their labor. St. Mary College, such a vital part of our community. St. John Hospital. Today the sisters are in 15 states, a far cry from their arrival 142 years ago. But we must remember that Leavenworth is and was the first city of Kansas. In 1859, it boasted 200 citizens. By 1861, 10,000. Today, we're 39,000. We were the jumping-off place for Western travelers. Leavenworth was a major starting point of the California and the Oregon Trail. You can still see the ruts of the old wagon trains when you visit Fort Leavenworth. Sometimes, though, when you really want to feel the nostalgia of the old frontier days, visit the old post chapel. Some afternoon, sit there and be relaxed. The Black Hills and the Mustang North. Yes, Custer was the fourth president, as was MacArthur, Eisenhower, Patton, and yes, Colin Powell. As you go from wayside to wayside, you will hear the stories and events that have given life to our community. You will hear about Dan Anthony. There was a colorful character. How many citizens close, they got in a gunfight on the main street of the community, shot another man, arrested. You'll hear about William Tecumseh Sherman and his brief practice in the ball practice here in Leavenworth. Carrie Nation and narratives about the railroad era, our Jewish heritage in bleeding Kansas. You will hear about the Buffalo Soldiers and their great efforts and contributions to the winning of the West. and their participation in the Spanish-American War and San Juan Hill. One thing we need to do today is recognize how all of this has come about. These waysides and their stories are community projects. The funding for them came from businesses and individual donations. The artwork was done by local artists. The narratives were written by local historians and local writers, and the recitations by local people. Truly, this is a hometown effort, something that we should all be proud of. We should be proud of the effort. We should be proud of our history. We should thrive on that history, and how it is told by these wayside markers. Again, thank you for letting me share a part of this today. Great step forward in recognizing Leavenworth's great historical past, something we should all be proud of. Thank you.
Wayside Tour, the Port of Leavenworth. A great success. They are the artists, the historians, and the narrators. We ask that you please hold your applause until everyone has been recognized. As your name is called, please stand and remain standing. The Port of Leavenworth, 1854 to 1875. Artist, Mr. Eric Ludwig. Historian, Mr. Kelvin Crowe. And narrator, Mr. George Moore. Lincoln at the Planters, December 5th, 1859. Artist, Mr. Ken Messicky. Historian, Mr. Kelvin Crowe. And narrator, Mr. Jack Walker. The Anthonys, Susan B. Anthony, Women's Champion. And Daniel R. Anthony, Publisher and Patriot. Artist, Ms. Betty Clay. Historian, Ms. Wanda Holder. And narrator, Mr. Ron Pache. Bleeding Kansas, 1854 to 1861. Artist, Ms. Marianne Keller. Historian, Mr. Mark Bierman. And narrators, Mr. Mark Bierman and Mr. Gary Brosnan. The Star of the West Saloon. Artist, Ms. Susan Feverly. Historian, Ms. Pamela Kontowitz. And narrator, Ms. Kim Meister. Frederick H. Harvey, Mr. Restaurant. Artist, Ms. Santa Murphy. Historian, Ms. Mariana Spain. And narrator, Mr. Phil Urban. William F. Cody, Buffalo Bill. artist Mr. Gene Young, historian Colonel Robert von Schlemmer, narrators Lieutenant Colonel Greg Bakian and Lieutenant Colonel James Gleisberg. Carry A Nation, Cyclone Carry. Artist, Miss Pat Ann Black. Historian, Ms. Wanda Holder. And narrator, Ms. Janet Ray. Stockton Hall, The Liberator and the Assassin. Artist, Ms. Becky Doyle. Historian, Mr. J.H. Johnson. And narrator, Ms. Miriam Sudi. The Landing Retail District, Our Jewish Heritage. Artist, Ms. Inga Cochran, historian, Sister Mary Lenore Martin, and narrator, Dr. Mary Davidson Cohen. General William Tecumseh Sherman, local lawyer and total warrior. Artist, Ms. Rebecca Wilkinson, historian, Ms. Pamela Kontowitz, and narrator, Lieutenant Colonel Don Vogt. The Great Railroad Era. Artist, Ms. Kathy Elliott, historian, Sister Mary Lenore Martin, and narrator, Mr. Mark Bierman. Leavenworth Federal Penitentiary, The Big House. Artist, Ms. Nancy Bowder. Historians, Ms. Nettie Graydon and Ms. Clara Vanderstay. And narrator, Colonel Robert von Schlemmer. Manufacturing Metropolis of the Midwest. Artist, Mr. Everett Ward. Historian, Mr. Gary Bradley. And narrator, Sister Rita McGinnis. Elegant Mansions. Artist, Ms. Jean Page, historian, Colonel Wes Ludwig, and narrators, Colonel Wes Ludwig and Ms. Kim Meister. Leavenworth, the first city of Kansas. Artist, Ms. Santa Murphy, historian, Mr. Mark Bierman, and narrator, Mayor Kenneth Bauer. St. Mary College and the Sisters of Charity of Leavenworth. Artist, Ms. Santa Murphy, historian, Sister Mary Lenore Martin, and narrator, Sister Susan Rickey. Broadway Homes. Artist, Ms. Pat Fuque. Historians, Mr. Gary Bradley and Ms. Ashley Jones. And narrator, Ms. Christine Bauer. Unsung Heroes. Artist, Mr. Chuck Martinson. Historian, Ms. Deborah Palmer. And narrator, Mr. Bruce Davis. Russell, Majors, and Waddell. Artist, Mr. Chuck Martinson. Historian, Ms. Sally Hatcher, and narrator, Colonel Roland Desert. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in showing our appreciation to these talented individuals for their hard work. At this time, we ask the artists, historians, and narrators to move to the artwork of their pedestal. portion of today's ceremony. Please join us in celebrating a walk back in time. We invite you to view the artwork of the historic Wayside Tour and visit with the artists themselves. Check your map for the locations of the various modules in the area where you can meet living historians. Then join us for additional festivities throughout the day, including fireworks tonight at 9:30.